Welcome to another episode of the Azure Enablement Show. Today we are going to talk about how you can assess your cloud journey using the Cloud Adoption Strategy Evaluator. Welcome back. My name is Thomas and I'm here with Kezia to talk about our new assessment platform and especially the Cloud Adoption Strategy Evaluator. So Kezia, obviously, it can be very challenging for customers if they are on their cloud journey to figure out what are all the things they need to do, how they build their strategy, what do they need to think about. So what are the challenges there? And can you tell me a little bit how the assessment can help with that?
Definitely. So a cloud journey starts probably in some meeting. Someone said an idea. I think we need to move to the cloud. That can happen a year or two before the work actually even starts. In that time in between, a lot of folks need to come together to make sure that this is going to go well. And so the assessment that we've put together helps with that. So let me show you. So this is Microsoft.com assessments, docs.microsoft.com/assessments. You'll land here, and there are a ton of assessments, but the one I'm going to focus on is the Cloud Adoption Strategy Evaluator. At a very base level, it's a questionnaire. So I'm going to start a new one. It is not pass fail. There are no tricky answers. It's more about tell us where you are in your journey, and we'll give you some good next steps to help you along that journey. And everyone's journey would be different. Some folks are really dialed into what the finances are going to be. That's cool. Some folks need help with the technology, and this is meant to help you figure that out. So if I start here, let's assume someone told me we're moving to the cloud at my company. Okay, where do we even start? Well, let's say for this pass, I only want to talk about the financial considerations and the technical considerations. There are other interests here that I could choose, but for now, let's just assume this is what I have information on. It asked me a couple of questions. Have I developed a financial model? Maybe. I think someone in finance might have done it. I'm not sure. I don't know. Next one. Do you understand the cost begin? Do I know which one? Yes, I know that we want a cost center model. Cool. And it goes down this way. There aren't that many questions. And then it will take me down to my results. It'll spit me over to my results. And basically, I'm a medium. And by medium is readiness medium here. So, okay, I'm not super low, not high. There are things I can do. And this is where it gets interesting here. The next three immediate things I can do, if I do nothing else and I just do these three things, it'll set me up for success. So the first one, cost estimator, because that's one of the things that I was interested in. Okay, it gives me this modeling. I'm looking at the tabs here, modeling, so I can figure out all the things that I might need, and it'll give me some pricing. It also, if I go back here, the template. Let's just say I need to start from scratch here. Here's a template I can start filling in a Word document. Who do I need to talk to? Who are the stakeholders? Why do we want to do this? What are my KPIs? In addition, there's a really fancy schmancy calculator here. I can go in and figure out what my VMs, what my accounts are, how much is this all going to cost, some example scenarios. All that is listed here in my recommendations. And then further down, in order to improve my results here, there are things I can come and read. So how do I create a financial model? What about investing more in the cloud? So I open this document and I can read it at my leisure. I don't have to do this on the call, but as you can tell, there are things I need to do.
No, that's pretty awesome. So let me quickly try to see if I understand everything correctly. So I go through, and if I build my cloud strategy, I obviously want to think about different things. And it's not just about technology, right? It's also about the organization, about spending, as you just showed, about like business cases and so on. So it actually, I enter all these questions and then I get some feedback on where I stand, depending on my answers. And then I get these recommendations, which are absolutely awesome. And even like what I loved is the template I can prepare and actually like fill out and get that information, as well as the cost estimation and so on. Now, you showed this assessment and the results. Obviously now I, as a, like as person in this organization, I have now these results. How can I share this with the rest of the organization?
Yes, there are a few ways we can share. Let me show you. So I can take the straight URL and send it to my colleagues on team. They would land on this page. Now, the important thing is you'll notice I'm logged in. You know, we need you to log in order to save and share and things like that. So I'm logged in. I can take the URL and put it on Teams. I can also do the share button and share it on Twitter, LinkedIn, Facebook, and email. Email is what we usually do. In addition, I can get all these recommendations downloaded into a CSV. So I click the button and it'll download the file for me. Some people prefer that because they want to take these action items and port them into ADO and have them as ticket items. But there are multiple ways to share. Now, one of the important things is these results are a snapshot. It's a snapshot in time. It's what I did today, what I know today. Let's assume that I take that CSV and all these recommendations and I go and do stuff. I go and do the things they wanted me to do. I come back and you'll see that it's the one I took today. So it says, okay, let me update that. And I can go and do a new one. And so a milestone here is considered like the next thing. Okay, I went and did a thing and now I come back and presumably my score will improve.
Okay, that is pretty cool. I think that is also a very important part to understand that it's not just a one-time thing. It's something I probably revisit multiple times and update depending on where I am in my cloud journey. So you showed us a little bit of like what kind of like questions are in this assessment, and obviously there are different types. But can you tell us a little bit more about what information customers should have ready and prepared to actually go out and fill out this assessment?
Yes. So my recommendation is the first time you take it from scratch. Don't prepare. Just go with what you know, because it's going to tell you basically what you don't know. And that's the whole point of this, to tell you, hey, you probably need to go talk to stakeholders. You probably need to go talk to the accounting team. You probably need to go figure out with your tech if we have the right skills. So come at this from scratch. Again, it's not pass, fail, no score. It'll just tell you these are the things you need to do next. From there, I would say that figure out with your stakeholders. Do we have that top level organizational alignment and agreement? That's where you would start. And then you work down the funnel. This is not something that one person is going to have all the answers to. You're going to need to talk to a ton of folks on your team. And together you bring the info here and hopefully set you up for a good cloud transition journey.
Yeah, that's awesome. What we talked about is like, obviously you showed me how like milestones work and that I can like obviously go and do that multiple times. But I know that maybe some customers are already on their cloud journey, right? And they haven't really done the assessment yet. Is it too late for them to now take the assessment, or when is the right time to actually take these assessments?
No, it's not. It's definitely not too late. But for example, if you're in the middle of your transition, you probably are already aligned with your stakeholders. The plan is there, everyone's signed off, but maybe you need to dig into the skilling of your folks. So do the technical folks, obviously you have folks that already know about the technology you're transitioning to, but maybe we need further. Maybe we need to make sure that all your product managers or the rest of the engineering team that are going to inherit these changes are aware of what needs to happen. And so, no, there's no bad time. Beginning, middle, and end is always, you'll always find something of value.
Oh, that's good. That's definitely good. And also another question that just came up for me is like, obviously you showed me that it shows me where I need to invest more and where I need to do for something. And it gives me recommendations on what to do. But how do I make these actionable?
So different folks do them in different ways. Some people like PowerPoint. There's a way to export this to PowerPoint and people work through there. Other folks take the straight CSV that I told you and they work through each item. They work line by line. And you can mark them as done there, or you can port it into ADO, Azure DevOps, and mark, you know, a regular ticketing, if you will. But a lot of the outcome here is conversations with your team. That's really what it is. It's less about, I need to go do this one specific thing, push this button. It's more about, I need to have this conversation.
No, I think this assessment really helps to figure out, okay, what do I need to do and what's actionable? And what I also like is that it very well integrates in the organization, right? It doesn't matter if I want to talk it like through in a PowerPoint presentation with my team, or if I want to directly have it in, as you mentioned, ADO with Azure DevOps, I can do that too. So there's many, many options there how I can actually leverage that. So if I want to know more about the Cloud Adoption Strategy Evaluator and how I take assessments, where do I go?
docs.microsoft.com/assessments.
That's awesome. That's very short and very good. Thank you very much, Keisha. And thank you, everyone, watching. And don't forget to go to aka.ms/adopt.